Welcome everybody. We are taking practice sheet number 21, details of blow of cork, page number 90. Now blow of cork is a kind of a valve which is to be manually opened or closed. It is mainly fitted on the boilers or some pressure vessels where you want to release the pressure manually. That time this valve is operated manually. Accordingly, a provision is made on this valve. Let us look at the given assembly and try to learn to draw the details. So page number 90 is here, and now you can see that there is a blow up cork assembly is shown. So you can see various parts. I'll just show them one by one. This part, if you could follow the section lines, this is part number 1. That is called as a body. Material is cast steel, quantity is 1. Then the second part is here. This part is gland. Material is cast steel, quantity is 1. Part number 3 is cork. This part, if you follow the section lines, this is a part number 3 called as a cork. Material is gunmetal, quantity is 1. Then this is part number 4. It is not shown, but you show it by center line. At this place there are sets, there are screws or bolts. You should call them as bolts, not screw. Bolt, part number 4, bolt, material MS, quantity 4, size of the bolt is going to be M12. So 4 such bolts are here for clamping the gland. Then at this place, again it is not shown, there is part number 5 called as packing. So the description for packing will be, you have to just write packing is the name of the part and material is felt and quantity as required. As required, that is quantity. So there are 5 things required, 5 parts are there. Now let us see how this assembly works. Now look here, as you see here, this is the body. Body has got one flange here and it has got one more flange over here. Now these flanges, the way they are shown, these flanges are shown without any holes, but in reality there will be holes on this so that this flange can be fitted to another flange or it can be mounted wherever it is required. Same thing, this flange also will have holes with the help of which this flange can be fitted to another flange so that pipe can come from this side with a flange and it will get connected here if required. So this body is fitted to a device like a boiler or a pressure vessel. Then the next thing is, let us look at this cork. This part is something like a conical shape. This is a conical shape here. Now to this conical shape, you can see here there is a window cut. So to the cone a window is cut. Suppose I draw it like this, it is like this. This is a part, and somewhere here they have cut one window. So this kind of a window is cut over here. Now what happens because of this window? This window is cut at two places. It is cut at two places means 180 degree opposite. There are windows cut like this. In fact, they should have shown this window cutout over here, but that they are not shown. This kind of a window cutout they should have shown in the drawing. Opposite window. Now what happens because of this window? See, right now this window is here and this is the other side which is coming in front of this place. Now this is the inlet and this is the outlet. That means the water or whatever is the liquid that is there, steam or water, that is going to flow from here and it is going to come out from here. At the moment it cannot come out because this is closed. There is a cutout over here, but this cutout is having the outside wall of this body, so it will not be open on this side also. So right now the valve is closed. Now suppose we rotate this cork by 90 degrees, then what will happen is this window will come at this position. This window which is there, this window will come in this position after you rotate. So once you rotate and it comes here, that time this cutout will come somewhere here and it is open, so that the flow of steam will take place like this after rotating by 90 degrees. Now if you rotate by other 90 degrees, since the window is there on both sides, both ways you can rotate, and either this cutout or this cutout will come here and you will be able to open the valve. When you again rotate it back, it will be closing again. Now how do you rotate it? For the purpose of rotation, you require some kind of a facility. So at this place, if you see, this part is a dead end, it is a closed end. But this shape of this end, if you see in the top view, you can see it is a 32 by 32 square end. So this end has got a shape of 32 square. So because of this 32 shape square, what happens is, say this size is 32, right now you are seeing this size, 40 size, so this is 40 you are seeing, which is this 40 across the diagonal, but this is across side is 32. So with the help of a box spanner of size 32, this box spanner you can insert from here. You can see there is a cutout here. So from this opening you can insert a box spanner, and this box spanner will be fitted on this 32 across flat projection, and with the help of that you will be in a position to rotate this particular cock so that the window will come in front of this opening and the valve will open. Now the other thing is, this is a part which is consisting of fluid, either steam or vapor or liquid. Now that can leak from here. It can leak from here because here this cock should freely move here. At the same time, it should prevent the leakage also. So this is two opposite things are required. It should be loose also so that it can rotate. It should be tight also, because otherwise there will be leakage. So how to achieve both the things at a time? It should be tight also, it should be loose also. Now that is done by providing a gland arrangement. Gland and packing arrangement is provided here, which we have learned earlier. So at this place here, in this space, there is a soft packing inserted, and after that, this part which is called as a gland, this gland is pressed down. How it is pressed down? We can see that here there are bolts. So these bolts, when you start rotating these bolts will try to come down. There is an internal threading here. So bolts will travel into this threading. So these bolts will take this particular gland down. So when the gland goes down, it will press the packing here. There is a packing here which will get pressed. And because of this taper shape given to this gland, the packing will be pressed on one side. And as a result, the leakage will be prevented from this place. For that to happen, there is going to be a threading provided on this side. So this diameter which is there, this diameter will be provided with a threading, which is not shown here, but this 62 diameter will be having a threading. I should add here M64. So M64 threading will be provided at this place, so that when you press it down, that time, no, it is not correct. There is no threading here. This is of course diameter 16, but there is a smooth diameter here. The threading is here, and these two surfaces which are in contact, they will come down, and as a result, the packing is preventing the leakage that is going to take place here. Now this is the top view, and you can see that I'll show it like this. This part, let me this size. This is this size, like a square shape. So this square shape size is there. This is square shape size. And this square shape size is belonging to this shape. So this is square shape. This also is a square shape for the gland. So the flange of the gland is square. This top of the body also is square. And then there are holes. You can see four holes are there. These four holes, they are there on the gland. And corresponding places here at the same distance, there are going to be threadings. So the M12 is, diameter 12 is written here. So at a distance of 80 by 80 center distance, here it is written 80 and 80. So at a distance of 80 by 80, there will be M12 threading here and there will be holes here, so that the bolt which will pass from there, that bolt will perform the work of pressing this gland down and pressing the packing down and preventing the leakage from here. So that is the arrangement here. This is a flange, which is this circular flange which is shown over here like this. So this flange is a part which has got a size which is here written here, 132 diameter. That is the size of the flange. So this is the description for this particular assembly called as a blow off cock. So I'll just repeat in brief. There's a body, there is a gland, then there is a cock, then there are bolts for the gland, and then there's a packing. The function of the gland is, the function of the blow off cock is to prevent or to close this particular flow. So this flow, suppose this flow is of a steam or a vapor or maybe even a liquid, then the flow is taking place once the window is aligned here. So by rotating this cock by 90 degrees, this window can be brought here so that the opening will be there and the liquid will flow like this. When you want to close, that time the cutout window will shift from here to here. For that, you have to rotate this particular end of the cock, which has got a square shape. Through this opening, you can pass on the box spanner and operate this particular knob and rotate this cock and change the position of this window, so that this window will be in front of this opening or it will be away from the opening, and as a result, it is possible to control the flow, and it is called as a blow off cock, or it is a kind of a valve. So this is the description. It is possible for us now to prepare the detailed drawings of these parts. You have to prepare the detailed drawings of all the parts except for packing. You have to write the description, and part number 4 bolt, you have to write the description. So no drawing, only description. And for part number 1, part number 2 and part number 3, there will be detailed drawings which you have to draw. There is no question of tolerance here, so you can just prepare the drawing. At the most, you can provide a tolerance on this dimension, 64 dimension, and this outside diameter, which is how much it is, 78 it is, 78 is here, and 80 diameter. This dimension is 80. So for 64 and 80, you can provide tolerance which will be of a precision clearance speed. I'll just show you here. Precision sliding fit, HH, H7, H6. So HH will be the tolerance. So you can write here HH. HH. This grade could be 77 or 66. This is basically related to the manufacturing process. So 7 and 6 is alright. You concentrate on HH combination, HH combination at both these places. For diameter 80 also, this is 80 diameter and this is 64 diameter. At both these places, there should be a very, very close running fit, clearance fit it is. So this could be the tolerances on two dimensions. So with this, we are in a position to prepare the detailed drawings of blow off cock, which is going to be factory sheet number P21.